It's just a plant. But men risk their lives for it, scaling down cliffs, dangling mid-air. For some, it's a risk worth taking. There are huge fortunes to be made. Every year, people come from far and wide to hunt for this herd. Some find fortune and the chance to lead new, better lives. For others, the herb spells death. This is their story. The herb that drives them to these extraordinary lengths is the stem of the dendrobe plant. It is highly prized in traditional Chinese medicine and is known as the gold hairpin. It's an apt name. In recent years, prices have skyrocketed to 40,000 yuan a kilo. The town is a remote place deep in the hills of Hunan. China's highest grade gold hairpin come from here. Ren Shan is Taiping's top gold hairpin hunter. Most of the people here are farmers, not Ren Shan. He's done well out of the gold hairpin. You won't find him out in the fields when the gold hairpin hunting season is over. Instead, he'll be here, playing cards with his friends. Wo Jianhai is getting ready for this year's gold hairpin season. His home is in Xixin, not far from Taiping. He's had a troubled life. First, his wife left him. A few years later, he was sentenced to 8 years in jail for his part in a brawl. Ever since his daughter got married and moved away, he's lived alone. Like many people around here, Guo makes a living from the dogwood tree. It's been dry this year. The dogwood crop has failed. There's no money to be made from dogwood this year. With winter fast approaching and Chinese New Year round the corner, another source of income. Guo is worried. He can't find anyone to go with him. The problem is that people here are very superstitious when it comes to the mountains. They won't venture up there unless the time is just right. But time is running out. He has to find someone before the snows come in November. Chinese New Year is another headache for Guo. His daughter and her family are coming. It's something to look forward to, but he'll need money to make it a good holiday. He has to get to those gold hairpins before they are buried in ice and snow. Li Xiaofei is a gold hairpin dealer in Xixia. He's originally from Taiping, so he knows all about the gold hairpin trade.
I 那十里要花30多一颗，干的15给它乘上15颗。
There are lots of gold hairpin products in Lee's shop. This precious herb gets its name because it faintly resembles the gold hairpins women used to wear. According to traditional Chinese medicine, it has many beneficial properties. It is good for the kidneys, helps people lose weight, and raises energy levels. The power of the gold hairpin has been recognized in Chinese medicine for thousands of years. The gold hairpin will only grow if the conditions are right. It thrives where days are warm and nights are cold. The Funiu Mountains in Henan are uniquely situated to provide these conditions. They lie on the border between China's cold northern climate zone and its warm southern one. Even when conditions are right, the plant grows extremely slowly. No wonder it's so scarce and so expensive. Not only that, it's extremely hard to find. And if you do find it, it's even harder to pick. That's because it likes growing on the sides of cliffs and precipices. Anyone who wants to turn this golden hairpin into real gold has to brave these deadly cliffs. Taiping is a remote place. Roads here are poor and transport is underdeveloped. People here live an isolated existence. The economy lags behind the rest of the country too. Even farming is an unreliable source of income. But it has one advantage. Medicinal herbs abound in these hills. Many of these command very healthy prices. Ren Shan's family has been involved in the gold hairpin business for many generations. His father was also a gold hairpin hunter. Not that it brought him much luck. Poverty has afflicted Ren Shan's life in many ways. He couldn't afford to get married until he was 30. His early business ventures failed, and he ended up mired in debt.
Ten years ago,
fate took a different turn for Ren Shan. Suddenly, the quickening pace of life in China caught up with sleepy Taiping. As the economy boomed, people got busier and busier, and their stress levels increased. People began to turn to traditional Chinese remedies like ginseng and gold hairpin. As demand increased, prices went through the roof. By 2008, a kilo of gold hairpin cost thousands of yuan. At last, prosperity trickled into Taiping and Ren Shan's life. Suddenly, this remote hillside town was transformed. Before long, half the population of Taiping was dependent on the gold hairpin trade. Between May and October, the gold hairpin picking season, the hillsides swarmed with men. It was like a gold rush, a gold hairpin rush. A Taiping farmer is lucky to scrape 1,000 yuan a year from the soil. With a bit of luck, a gold hairpin hunter can earn that much in a single day. For these impoverished farmers, there was wealth beyond their wildest dreams waiting for them in the hills. But there was a price to be paid.
我们这大约，我说的说着都摔坏了12个，都摔死了，都是下来，有时间是绳子折了，有些是绳子捆完叉了，这个啥的摔死了，有些是他捞住这哨子干哨子，这个干哨子一折，摔坏了。
Zhang Lin is 62 years old. He used to go with Ren Shan on his gold hairpin hunting expeditions. A single accident put him off picking for life. Zhang Lin likes the quiet life now, looking after his birds and doing some wood carving. Guo Jianhai is not a professional hunter. But he's going to try his luck anyway. Guo has found some people willing to go with him. He knows them well. They used to go gold hairpin hunting with his father. Seventy-year-old Zhang Yong'an, 60-year-old Zhang Taidan, and 45-year-old Zhang Hongwei. It's not exactly the dream team, but it'll have to do. They're headed for Huangshan'an, more than 10 kilometers from the village. Guo is going there for a reason. He wants to try his luck on a cliff there. Years before, he thought he smelt a gold hairpin there. This is as far as the road by car. They'll have to walk the rest of the way. It'll take 2 days. It's 6:30 a.m. For Ren Shan, the hunting season is about to begin. For the next 2 months, he'll be out combing the mountainsides for gold hairpins. The race is on the moment they set foot on the mountainside. There's nothing easy about tracking down this precious herb. They don't go out in the open waiting for the men to come along and pick them. They hide away where there's just the right balance of light and shade. Anyone with a knack of finding the spots these secretive plants like to call home, steal fortune. Meanwhile, Li Xiaofei has a customer. These are potted gold hairpin plants. Although it can be cultivated, most believe that dried wild gold hairpin is more powerful than artificially cultivated one. The gold hairpin trade has been booming over recent years. Li is trying to stock up with this year's harvest. He's not exactly optimistic. Sometimes it seems that Ren has gold hairpin on the brain. His never-ending quest for the herb has taken him all over China. Danger lurks everywhere in the woods. Guo and his men arrive at camp. After a bit of a trek, they get to the foot of the cliff. Gold hairpin hunters look for them in two ways. Sometimes they start at the foot of a cliff and make for the places where they see it or think it is likely to be. At other times, they start at the top of the cliff and scale down the cliff face. It's a risky business. Thank you.
够了，要有人看，他回来了没有？这现在有这都是不跑矿体，不带着不想去了都看看。这是第八个玩意，都换了，一收潮都是不轻。跟朋友呢，光收潮。
Chen Xiru, Renshan's wife, never goes with her husband on his trips into the mountains. She is in charge of the cultivated gold hairpin plants that her husband sells. Renshan is not just a gold hairpin hunter, he's also a dealer. And with decades of experience under his belt, he's at the top of his game. Last year alone, 25 kilos of the precious herb passed through his hands.
哎，我想最少还有40个人在山上，都在给我搞了。我也嫌我大一点。这几十个人凑到一坨，自然说现在才有才四公斤多一点，不到五公斤多了。我就是等着这个四五公斤弄下来，我就给拿回来。
Renshan has made a lot of money from the herb. In 2010, he bought houses for his two sons. However, the purchase used up most of his savings. That's why he's back on the mountainside.
因为我收获这个收的太大了，不想让他们说再。受那大的罪，没想着说多八叉一个，多攒一个，到老的时候你又花了呢。如果他妈多留一个，少一个。
李小飞 can't wait any longer. He can't get any gold hairpin. He'll have to stock up with the cultivated stuff. No wonder he's having difficulties. Years of over exploitation.Have depleted wild stocks.
I said, I'm going to call a phone call. I said, I'm going to have a good day. They are not going to be able to. I said, I'm going to have a good day.
Where are you going? You're going to go first. You're going to have a lot of money. You're going to buy it. And you're going to have a lot of money. I'm going to drive the car back. I'm going to have a lot of money. When he was in his house, he was waiting for two people. They were waiting for him.
However, Li Xiaofei's decision doesn't make it any easier to get any. As night falls, Guo Jianhai and his men return to camp empty-handed. They make up their minds to try the top of the cliff. As far as they know, it's untrodden territory. They'll be the first hunters to try their luck there. Maybe their luck will change. It's a big risk, though.
Mm-hmm.
就这，反正路都是跟着。
Guo and his men finally get to the foot of the cliff. They are surprised how difficult it is to climb.
那时候那一波全部是灯，可不好上。等你上边，等打下来，好着上。
It might be a shortcut, but it's still a tough climb.
这地方可是过不去，没人上，这是高处啊。没人上，没人上那就说不了还有药，还有手术啊。
Night falls quickly in the mountains. Time is running out.
Thank you.
Finally, Wen Shan finds a gold hairpin. Today, it's Ren Shan's brother, Ren Zhongwei's turn to scale the cliff. Ren Shan waits below as his Things haven't gone according to plan. Ren Shan's misjudged the situation. The rope is too short. They'll have to tie the ropes together. That's not an easy thing to do where they are. Ren Zhongwei stands on tiptoes. He's in great danger. If the rock under him gives way, he's done for. Zhang Taidan looks like he has got something. It's not gold hairpin. It's a kind of durum wheat. It's nowhere near as valuable as gold hairpin, but at least it's something. Guo Jianhai was hoping for more than this. He decides to have a go himself. This will be his last shot. Half an hour later, the problem with the rope is solved. Ren Shan is not happy when he sees his brother taking the little gold hairpins. Guo is still searching. Guo was at the end of his tether. Their search turns out to be a fruitless one. It's time to call it a day. The gold hairpin won't change Ren Shan's life much now, but it's had a big effect on his family. Ren Shan Chao, Ren Shan's son, works in the gold hairpin trade in Shisha. He has no shop and doesn't advertise, and yet his business thrives. Ren Shanqiao and his younger brother live in Shisha. They don't go into the hills with their father. Their lives are very different from his. Ren Shan rarely sees his sons. Their lifestyle doesn't exactly meet with his approval.
They 挣了是包啊。
然后我也吃过苦的，他们没有吃过苦，他不知道那个吃苦是啥。咱只想着那是吃苦了，这个啥呢？你仔细细水长流。他们是酒有了酒的话，酒没有了咱就抓茬，就是这个成的。
现在
All sorts of gold hairpin products are on display in Xixia, but not all of them are quite what they seem. As prices have gone up, in the past year alone, the retail price of gold hairpin has risen from 20,000 yuan to 40,000 yuan per kilo. So too has the amount of fake and substandard stuff.
This 这不算好，2000多的都卖完了，还有6000多的也卖完了。
The gold hairpin has become a status symbol in Xixia. It's often given as a gift. Even a tiny hairpin makes people happy. People rarely think about the cost of this precious herb. For some, money is no object.
我感觉它也不是啥一个特效药，反正我没有听谁说这个东西跟某某某哪个病治好了。
现在人们都认可，哪个价格高，哪个就是好的；哪个价格低，哪个就不好了。就这个今天，以后也很可能会涨到十几万，也有可能，因为太稀少了。
Few realize just how rare it has become. Guo Jianhai gave up on his quest for the gold hairpin. Although he came home empty-handed from his last trip, his luck seems to have improved. When we see him a few months later, he's the proud owner of a gold hairpin. It cost him a lot of time, effort, and a sprained ankle.
I think that I have a都能好着，那个石头啊，跟别不一样。站到那个地方，站到那个下面看，看着那个时间还没开花，看着老乡顶不真。这后来这个把绳背上绑到树上，你知道这个大金钗绑着双，捞着绳下来看，一看都是。
This is an authentic gold hairpin, weighing about 200 grams. Its present market value is 6,000 yuan. However, 2 months later, it remains unsold.
知道的人多的很，来我家看的人也多，但是我都没给他。他给的价格不行，也就是说，一传货的价格，我不给他。
Though Guo has yet to sell his gold hairpin plant, Ren Shan is never short of paying customers. Today, one of his main customers pays him a visit.
这外头也吃好几份了，他是这辈子这种劲子，一路是干着。那这辈子这两天我说你也不在乎那，你给我听，那好再说了，你怎么说呢？那我在电话问了，那他不放假。
中了，你给我说谁家？
不中了，俺们都走五九折。
你给我说那啥吧。
一万八，这两户一万五，那个一万八。
那一万八。
卖你真鲜货也不少。
那一万八不中。
中了，俺们都走五九折。
东西咱不能装，你就是装谁，我就赚了一回钱。咱他们这是这老几辈，这辈子都是干这。
那就成吧。
估计挣多少钱我也是干了。
A single piece of gold hairpin costs over 10,000 yuan. Extreme caution is needed on both sides.
一公斤二两半算是，你掂你自己称。
一公斤二两半，压么二斤半，
二斤半。
啊，
这两倍是吧？这两倍是16,000，16,00025,000，算一个。
钱都得了啊！
啊，钱得了。
钱下了啊！
好，我省了。
哎，那你走吧。
Guo Jianhai is now getting more attention from the police than potential customers. 2 days ago, someone reported a stolen gold hairpin plant. Guo's old pal, Zhang Taidan, claims Guo stole the plant from him. The policemen take the plant away for forensic examination. Guo is sad. The skyrocketing price of gold hairpin has put two old friends at odds with each other. But it's not all bad news for Guo. He has some visitors, his daughter and grandson. He hasn't seen them for a long time. She lives in another town now, and she couldn't come last Chinese New Year because of heavy snow. Although Guo can handle the hills and valleys, holding a baby is another matter. At dinner, Guo doesn't drink. It's the first time he hasn't had a drink for a long time.
你快去吧吧。行，你快，把这去，把院，把院他，把老他，帮恁。啊，好，你快吧。你慢点啊。行。
The results of the forensic examination come out a few days later. Guo's gold hairpin has nothing to do with Zhang Taidan's missing one. The policemen return Guo's gold hairpin. Shortly after, Guo comes to a decision. Even though his ankle has recovered, he's not going into the mountains again. He wants a more stable and regular life now. Li Xiaofei hasn't bought any gold hairpins recently. He doesn't see much of a future in the business.
我觉得他价钱有点太高，我觉得还是想过去一样，之前亏钱也行，因为他们抽到过高，但是卡尺落下来，一大部分人都坑。Ren
Shan still hunts the gold hairpin. It's become part of his life, but he doesn't want his sons to carry on in the trade. The herb is getting scarcer now, and gold hairpin hunters are a dying breed. Ren Shan could be the last generation of his family to look for gold hairpin on the cliffs high up in the mountains.
I'm not sure what I'm doing.